Hello and welcome back to the studio. We are here today to work on a standing pose called Warrior One. This pose is good for strengthening your legs, working on balance, a little bit of core engagement, as well as just an opportunity to sense where your body is in space. There's a lot going on in the pose. And you'll notice if you're a regular yoga practitioner that there are some differences in the way that I teach it. So just pay close attention and maybe give this a try at home. So there are a few ways to get into the pose. I most often start my students in mountain pose, usually standing up at the top of the mat. So grounding down through the heels, primarily facing forward, breathing in. The arms come up, and as you breathe out, we step a leg back. And I'll start with the right leg back. But not only stepping it back, we're going to step it back and out to the side. So coming back, and then coming out to the side somewhat. We want a nice wide base here because this pose can really challenge your balance. So don't just step that leg back, also step it wide. To the side of the mat. So arms come up. I like to have the torso at an angle to start. The back foot is facing forward at least a little bit. Doesn't have to be a whole lot. The front leg is facing forward. I start with two straight legs and ask you to breathe in and reach those fingers up and I stretch for the arms. And as you breathe out, let your pelvis sink down between your legs. That automatically invites a lunge to the front leg. And here you can experiment with where that foot placement is challenged by balance already. So taking a few breaths right here, we press into the outside edge, the pinky side edge of that back foot. Arms are reaching up and we have a nice lunge in the front leg. Breathing right here, noticing if you tend to let that front knee cave in, a lot of us, in fact, most of us tend to do that. I encourage you to try to stack that knee somewhere between the second and third toe. What that does is spread out the compression of the knee. Most folks, if they have a knee injury, it's on the inside of the knee. So we try not to let our knee cave in too much. Do what you can. My role as your teacher is to walk around the room and try to kind of guide you to see that your knee is just in the best possible place for you. So again, breathing here, we're building some leg strength, particularly the quadriceps right here. You can remain in here in what's often called warrior one and a half because the torso is facing at an angle. If you would like to guide your gaze or your torso towards the front of the mat, the front of the room, please have the movement come from the shoulders. So your hips are going to stay where they are. We don't try to square our hips towards the front of the room. That's really not best for that back knee. We want to keep that back knee, back foot all in one nice long line. So if you do want that torso to come towards the front of the room, we want to twist here at the mid-back, at the thoracic spine, and leave the pelvis right where it is. And I often have my students take several breaths right here, just finding their place in space. This can get quite tiring for the front leg. For the first probably year that I took this pose, you would often see me taking a break. If that's you, take the break. There's no sense being uncomfortable in the pose. Take a little break, and then when you're ready, invite that lunge back in. Arms are another thing that sometimes start to tire quickly, or maybe you have a shoulder injury. If that's you, guess what? You can keep your hands on your hips. It's always your practice. My students hear this all the time. It's just an option to take a twist here. You might feel better keeping your torso at an angle. That, my friends, is Warrior One. Lots of customizations, some new cues that you may not be familiar with, but in my studies of anatomy, I think are probably best for most bodies. So I encourage you, come on to class Tuesday nights at 7:30. Saturday mornings at 10 is when you will most often see this standing pose. See you next time.